Now we continue, inshallah ta'ala, then with the tafsir of Surah Al-Balad. We reach, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ. Verily, we have created man in kabad. And kabad here has two meanings. First of all, meaning man is created on the perfect shape, on statue or mold. مستقيم, straight, walking on his feet, having his head up, and his body is upright. However, with respect to the animals, they are on the opposite, in the sense that their rear and their head are on the same level. However, with respect to the children of Adam, the head is above the body. And this is as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ, as in Surah At-Teen. Indeed, verily we have created man في أحسن تقويم, in the best stature and mold. This is one meaning. The other meaning of كبد, verily we have created man in كبد, is مكابدة, hardship, toil, suffering. Meaning man faces difficulties in this life and in seeking sustenance. Also, he faces difficulties with himself in terms of striving, try to direct it to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the act of obedience and to keep away from acts of disobedience. And this type of jihad of striving, it is more difficult than that in seeking sustenance, especially if a person is surrounded by a bad environment, a deviant environment. He will end up being like a stranger in such an environment, and therefore he will suffer with self-strive and with also with people and dealing with them. And therefore the question is, would it be possible for this ayah to mean both meanings? Yes. And we have known the rule in tafsir that if the ayah has two meanings and there is no contradiction or opposition between the meanings, then take it on both meanings. Why? Because the Quran is ashmal wa awsa, is vast and comprehensive. However, if there is opposition or a kind of contradiction between them, then between these meanings, then فَانْظُرْ الرَّاجِحِ, then look for that which will be preponderating. Example, like the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah 2:228 concerning the divorced woman, وَالْمُطَلَّقَاتُ يَتَرَبَّصْنَ بِأَنفُسِهِنَّ ثَلَاثَةَ قُرُوءٍ, and women shall wait as regards their marriage for three قروء. One meaning for قروء is the menstrual periods. The second is purity, ritual purity. Okay. The correct one is ثلاث حيضات, three menstrual cycles, وما بينهن من الأطهار, and that which is between them from purity, between the menstrual cycles. In this case, in our case with this ayah, alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, in this ayah, kabad, therefore toil, comprises both meanings. Meaning that the good and straight shape and form of man and the hardship that he faces in this life. أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَنْ لَنْ يَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ أَحَدٌ. The next verse, please. Does man, he think that none can overcome him? عليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Thinks that none can overcome him? Meaning that man thinks that in his strength, عليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته, that no one can overcome him. especially when he is in prime rigor and strength and pride and arrogance. He says, لا أحد يقدر علي. No one can overcome me. أنا أعمل ما شئت. I can do whatever I wish. ومنه قوله تبارك وتعالى, and the like is the saying of Allah, فأما عاد فاستكبروا في الأرض بغير الحق وقالوا من أشد منا قوة. And as to Ad, the people of Ad, they disdained in the land and they were arrogant unjustly. And they said, who is mightier than us in strength? قال الله تعالى in response, أولم يروا أن الله الذي خلقهم هو أشد منهم قوة. Don't they see that Allah who created them is أشد منهم قوة, is more powerful and mighty than them, as in 41:15, as in 41 Surah Fussilat verse 15. Yes, indeed, Islam Star. I mean, it's all relevant. It's all relevant. The same thing, Fir'aun and others. It's all relevant. So, a man, when he is in a state of good health, and he's at prime and rigor in his youth, he thinks that no one can overcome him. He thinks even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot overcome him. And this is very clear with respect to the kafir. With respect to the kafir, to the disbeliever. However, with respect to the believer, he knows أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَادِرٌ عَلَيْهِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all able to overcome him. And that Allah is able to do whatever he wishes. Therefore, فَيَخَافُ مِنْهِ, therefore he will have awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then man says, the next verse please, يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا. يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا. He says boastfully and arrogantly. When he is wealthy and Allah gives him from the sustenance, he says, I have wasted wealth in abundance. Meaning in abundance concerning his lusts and entertainments. يقول عز وجل أيحسب أن لم يره أحد. Does he think that none can overcome him? أيحسب أن لم يره أحد. Does he think that none sees him? Can you repeat please? Which one can I repeat? Okay, I'll repeat the verse. Okay, fine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about man, يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا, meaning he says boastfully and arrogantly, I have wasted wealth in abundance. You know, when he is healthy and he is at his peak and prime and so forth, and when he has wealth he says, well, you know, I spend that in abundance. In what? Spending it in what? For his lust, shahawatu, for his lust, and malazzatu, his enjoyments. يقول عز وجل أيحسب أن لن يره أحد. Does he think that none sees him? Does he think that none sees him in his spending? Spending it in that which is of no benefit. And in all of this, as you can tell, تهديد للإنسان أن يتغطرس. This is a stern warning for man, lest he continues in his arrogance. Because of thinking he is mighty because of his physical strength or because of his wealth in abundance that he has. قال الله تعالى, then after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 8, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. Does he think that none sees him? Haven't we not made for him two eyes and a tongue and two lips and shown him the two ways, and النَّجْدَيْنِ, the good and bad? أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ, meaning this through which he can see. These eyes تؤديان إلى القلب ما نظر إليه الإنسان. These eyes will reflect what it sees, it will reflect it to the heart. So So if he looks at something unlawful, it will be a sin. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And if he looks at something which will be a means of nearness to Allah, then he will be successful, he will be a winner. And if he looks at something which is allowable, mubah, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُحْمَدُ وَلَا يُذَمْ. And if he looks at something which is allowable, then he is going to be neither praised nor blamed, مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ هَذَا النَّظَرُ مُفْضِيًا إِلَى مَحْظُورٍ شَرْعِيٍ. As long as this sight which he, the thing that which he was looking at, this gazing, is leading to something which is illegal. In this case, he will acquire a sin through such a look. Then وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنَ. A lisan, a tongue, he uses to talk with. شَفَتَيْن, two lips, regulates his speech. Regulates his speech. And these are from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, umman. Because through the tongue and the lips, man is able to express himself. Otherwise he wouldn't. I mean, if he was speechless, how can he express that which is in his heart? كيف يعلم الناس بما في نفسه? How people will know as to that which is in himself regarding, except through perhaps signaling. And this will be something, you know, it'll be hard. It will be hard for him and difficult for him, and it will be hard for others also as well. Yet it is from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he made for man a tongue as well as lips. And it is also from the amazing matters manifesting the ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يأتي النطق من هواء. The pronunciation, the utterance comes from air, which comes from the lungs, and passes it through special paths. It passes through something, it will become a letter. And if it passes through another path, it will become another letter. Yet it is the same, it is the same air from one source coming, but it falls and passes through different passages on capillaries, very minute, very fine, in the throat and also in the lips and also in the gum, on the gum. All of these form the letters that we utilize in our speech. So that's why you find the letter ba, the letter sheen, all of them are coming from using the same air that comes from the ri'ah, from the lungs. Yet they differ depending on the passages they take. In the throat and in the mouth. And this is from the perfect ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. And show him the two ways, the good and evil. Meaning we made the good of evil, the good and evil clear to him. The other meaning is هَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ, meaning دَلَلْنَاهُ عَلَى مَا بِهِ غِذَاؤُهُ وَهُوَ السَّدْيَانِ. We directed him and guided him to the source of his nourishment, and these are the breasts. فَإِنَّهُمَا نَجْدَانِ. They are two lofty things, because they come on top of the chest. فَهَدَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَهُوَ رَضِيعٌ. هَدَاهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَهُوَ رَضِيعٌ لَا يَعْرِفُ. Allah directed it, him and guided him to them, yet he doesn't know. From the time he comes out and his mother gives birth to him, يَطْلُبُ الثَّدِي. He seeks the breast. And the one who informed him is Allah Azza wa Jal. فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنَّتَهُ عَدَى هَذَا الْإِنسَانِ. And thus man is manifesting his favor on man from the time he is born, seeking النجدين, seeking the two breasts. and in the his mother's womb, alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, he takes the nourishment from the abdominal cord because he has no other way. Through this abdominal cord, umbilical cord, the blood comes carrying all the nourishment he needs so that he becomes living until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings him out as a babe. فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَ. Verses 11 and verse 12 and 13 please. فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَ. But he has not attempted to pass on the path that is steep. That is the path which will lead to goodness and success. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَ. And what will make you know the path that is steep? Then Allah defines it in the next verse. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَ. This man who is saying أَهْلَكْتُ مَالًا لُبَدًا, I spend all this wealth abundantly. This man, هَلَّ اقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَ. هَلَّ اقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَ. Would he attempt to pass the path that is steep, meaning the path which would lead to goodness and success? And الاقتحام, اقتحام would mean here attempt to pass with hardship, بمشقة. العقبة in Arabic, الطريق في الجبل الوعر. العقبة means the rough, rugged mountain terrains. Certainly the passing of these paths is what is very difficult. وما أدراك ما العقبة. This exclamation now, العقبة, للتشويق والتفخيم أيضا, is for yearning and longing and magnification, meaning ما الذي أعلمك شأن هذه العقبة, who informed you concerning this عقبة, which Allah made clear later and when he said فك رقبة, it is the freeing of a neck of a slave, or إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة, or giving food in a day of hunger, on day of famine. يتيما ذا مقربة, to an orphan near of kin. أو مسكينا ذا متربة, or to a miskin, a poor, cleaving to dust out of misery. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله. فك رقبة. Let's take the first one. المعنى الأول, the first meaning of فك رقبة, which is the freeing of a neck slave. So this is the freeing of a slave owned by his master. So the master frees him, or a person frees him if he is owned by a master. The second meaning is فك رقبة من الأسر, freeing a captive, freeing a captive. فإن فكاك الأسير من أفضل الأعمال. Freeing a captive is one of the best deeds to, you know, in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal. And it is known that the captive may not be freed except by a ransom. And it could be of a heavy, heavy ransom. لا يقتحمها. Here is the meaning. لا يقتحمها. No one will attempt to pass this path to free this slave except the one who has faith in Allah Azza wa Jal, who knows بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ will bestow in return that which he spent in this cause, and that he will reward him for that charity that he gave to free this captive or this slave. Then he said the other thing is إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمِ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ, is to give food in day of hunger. Famine. Because people could be afflicted with hunger due to low produce from fruits and vegetation. Bad voice again.
is it better now?
Or due to, it's not better. Oh. طيب الحمد لله. It was okay, الحمد لله. Or due to some illnesses. Illnesses, yes. It may be possible that a person eats and does not get full. And this occurred in places. People used to eat but not feeling, you know. You would feel, you would see them eating sometimes, you know, that which would be eaten by 10 people, but not feeling full due to an illness. And they end up dying. And this is from al-masagib, yawmin bi masghaba, of famine. Or it may be due to low produce, because, you know, with trees giving very little of fruits and vegetation. And people die out of hunger. Or they may leave their homes and towns. And the other thing is, yatiman dha maqraba, to an orphan near of skin. Al-yateem, who is al-yateem? The orphan. The definition of the orphan, we defined this yesterday, but the definition of the orphan is the one, man mata abuhu qabla an yablugh, is the one who his father dies before he reaches the age of puberty. Whether this child is a boy or a girl, male or female. However, if he reaches the stage of puberty, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَكُونُ يَتِيمًا, that he is no more considered as an orphan, because he reached the stage of puberty and he is separate. However, if the person loses his wife, his mother rather, if his mother dies, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَكُونُ يَتِيمًا, then he is not considered an orphan. Contrary to what most people think, in fact. They think that the orphan is the one who lost his wife, and this is incorrect. The yatim is the one whose father died. The maqraba, meaning of kinship, close in kinship. So the yatim is entitled for to be honored and to be given from the charities. And if he is of kin, that will be even of more required, because he has it through another angle, which is the angle of kinship. So the one now who is qualified with being an orphan and a kin, then spending upon him is from اقتحام العقبة, is from the passing of this steep and rough terrain, quote unquote. أو مسكين ذا مطربة, or to مسكين. What is the مسكين? Who is the مسكين? المسكين هو الذي لا يجد قوته ولا قوت عياله. The مسكين, the poor, is the one who doesn't find that which he needs and what his family needs. المطربة مكان التراب, meaning here cleaving to dust. مسكين, ليس بديه شيء إلا تراب. He is poor, he doesn't have anything except تراب, dust. So it is also known, إذا قيل عن الرجل ليس عنده إلا تراب, if it is said that a person doesn't have, I mean, he has nothing except dust, then it is known that he is very poor, meaning he doesn't have food, he doesn't have clothing, he doesn't have wealth. سهو مسكين ذو مطربة, cleaving to dust out of misery. ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة. Then after that, بعد ذلك, ليس محسنا اليتامى والمساكين فقط, بل هو ذو إيمان. then he became one of those who believe. It's not only that he, you know, spends and gives the poor and the orphan and you know, and those in famine. No, on top of that, فهو ذو إيمان. He becomes one of those who believe. آمن بكل ما يجب الإيمان به. He believed in everything that is dutiful upon him to believe in. وقد بين الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام made it clear the things which we must believe in. When he was asked by Jibreel عليه السلام about Iman, what is faith, he said, الإيمان أن تؤمن بالله. Believe is that you believe in Allah. Faith is that you believe in Allah. وملائكته, his angels. وكتبه, his books. ورسله, his messengers. واليوم الآخر, the last day. والقدر خيره وشره. والقدر خيره وشره. And the pre-decree, the pre-decree, it's good and it's bad. Then Allah says, وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة. And recommend one another to perseverance and patience. And also recommend one another to pity and compassion. تواصوا بالصبر. They recommend one another to perseverance. You know, الصبر, perseverance, is of three kinds. الصبر is of three kinds. Sister Islamic knowledge, جزاك الله خير. الصبر, patience, patient, perseverance, is of three types. The first type, صبر على طاعة الله. صبر على طاعة الله. Which means patient perseverance regarding the acts of worship, in worshiping Allah. One needs to be patient. This is the first type. صبر نعم. The other is صبر عن معصية الله. The other is perseverance concerning sins, meaning one should be persevering in avoiding. This requires perseverance in to avoid sin. It requires perseverance to avoid sin. And the third, صبر على أقدار الله المؤلمة. Perseverance regarding the painful pre-decrees of Allah. All these three matters, or these three types of perseverance, were combined in the messengers عليهم الصلاة والسلام and their followers. Here is our messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم persevering in worshipping Allah, striving في سبيل الله, in the path of Allah. يدعو إلى الله, inviting to the way of Allah and to Allah. ويؤذى ويعتدى عليه بالضرب, facing harm, being beaten. حتى هم المشركون بقتله. The mushriks were about to kill him, yet he was صابر محتسب. He was persevering, seeking the reward of Allah. He was also صابر عن معصية الله, persevering to avoid the sins and wrongdoings. He didn't betray anyone, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Not belying anyone. Yet also متق لله تعالى بقدر ما يستطيع, fearing Allah to the best of his ability. He was also صابر على أقدار الله. He was also patient regarding, persevering regarding the pre-decree of Allah. Many times he was hurt for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. أليست قريش قد آذوه حتى إذا رأوه ساجدا تحت الكعبة أمروا من يأتي بسلى ناقة فيضعه على ظهره وهو ساجد عليه الصلاة والسلام. Isn't it that Quraysh, the pagans, used to hurt him until one day they saw him prostrating by the Kaaba. They ordered someone to bring the filth of fetus of a she-camel and to place it on his shoulders while he was prostrating عليه الصلاة والسلام. Until someone went and informed Fatima, and she was young, his daughter عليها السلام, and she came and took off this filth from his back. And then he made dua, invoked Allah against them, and named them one by one. And by Allah, in the battle of Badr, they were laying dead, all of them whom he named صلى الله عليه وسلم, one by one. Allahu Akbar. In all of this, he was persevering. This is the way of the messengers. Yusuf alayhi salam, Prophet Yusuf, he persevered concerning the pre-decree of Allah. You know that he was thrown in the bottom of a well and was hurt in the cause of Allah Azza wa Jal in the prison, yet he was persevering, seeking the reward. لم يتضجر, he didn't go into rejection and rage as to that which was befalling him. Then Allah says وتواصوا بالمرحمة, and they recommend each other, and they recommend each other to pity and compassion, being merciful to each other, also being merciful to the creatures from animals and such. He is merciful man, the believer, to his fathers, his mothers, his children, sons and daughters, his brothers, his sisters, his uncles, his maternal aunts, and his aunts, and so forth. Merciful to others, merciful to the animal, to his camel, to his horse, to his donkey, to his cow, to his sheep. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ارحموا من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء. Be merciful to those on earth, the one who is above heaven will be merciful to you. This hadith is reported in At-Tirmidhi, and he At-Tirmidhi رحمه الله said حديث حسن صحيح. This is a good and authentic hadith. أولئك, meaning all of those qualified with these qualities, أولئك أصحاب الميمنة, they are those on the right hand, meaning the dwellers of paradise. They will be given their records in their right hands, and the reckoning will be ease and swift, and they will return to their families in joy. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا, and as to those who disbelieved in our ayat, our signs, our verses, etc., هُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْمَشْأَمَةِ, they are those on the left hand, the dwellers of the fire of hell. عَلَيْهِمْ نَارٌ مُؤْصَدَةٌ, the fire will be shut over them, meaning that they will be enveloped by the fire without an opening or a window or an outlet. They will never be able to leave it. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلنا من الذين آمنوا. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who believe. وعملوا الصالحات and acted righteously. وتواصوا بالصبر and they recommended one another to perseverance. وتواصوا بالمرحمة and recommended one another to pity and compassion. إنه سميع مجيب أجيب. He is the one all hearing, the one who answers the invocations. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward our Sheikh Muhammad bin Saleh al-Uthaymeen رحمه الله for all of his efforts and especially this one which we are discussing, the tafsir of part 30 of the Noble Quran. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Mic is free.